If you are an IT admin and you use HPE ProLiant service in your IT infrastructure, then stay here. My name is Jasmin, and I'm working as a senior system engineer at Tesla. In this video, I'll show you how you can monitor the hardware components of your physical servers using PRTG. So there are three steps involved in procedure of monitoring of your target HPE ProLiant service. In the first step, you need to enable SNMP on the ILO interface. In the second step, you need to add HPE ProLiant as a device in PRTG. And in the third step, you need to add sensors that will help you to monitor different hardware components. Now I will show you how to do that. This is my PRTG UI. In this PRTG, I added my HPE ProLiant service. Now I will add a sensor to show you what kind of the hardware components or the metrics we can get using PRTG. So first I will add a system sensor. So I will click on add sensor. And then I will type HPE ProLiant. And you can see here we have five different sensors. These sensors will help us to monitor different hardware components. First, we will start with SNMP, HPE ProLiant System Health Sensor. I'll click on Add. And this is initial configuration, nothing to configure here. Then I will click on Create. And then PRTG will create a sensor that will help me to monitor different hardware components on my target HPE server. Okay, this sensor is added. Now I will open my sensor. I will do a manual scan to establish connection between PRTG and my target HPE server. And now I can see this sensor is in green state, which means it's healthy. Now when I look at the channels that I have here, I can see that this sensor is able to monitor different components, including CPU fan status, this controller status, different state of our fans, also the power consumption and temperature of different components. So it seems this sensor is in healthy state, which is good. Now I will go back to my HPE ProLiant server, and then I will add a second sensor. Now under the physical disk, I will click Add Sensor, and then I will type HPE ProLiant server again, and then I will search for physical disk sensor. I click on physical disk sensor, and now the MetaScan in PRTG will discover all available disks. I select all of them, and then I will click on Create. Now when I click on Create, PRTG will create sensor for each of these selected disks. If I navigate to one of these sensors, then I will be able to see the health state of my sensor. I navigated to one of them, I will click Manual Scan, and then in a few seconds, this sensor will be in a green state. Okay, when I look at the channels that are within my sensor, I can see different channels, including the drive condition, write and read errors, smart status, sectors read and written, pressure all passed, and different other channels related to my disks. As you can see, this disk is also in the health state, which is good, so that we can proceed with the next sensor. I will go back to my HPE ProLiant server. Okay, and now I will navigate to logical disk. Now I add sensor. I do the same procedure. I type HPE ProLiant. I select my logical disk sensor. And then I click on Create. PRTG will do a Metascan and discover all the logical disks on my server. I select them and I click Create. Now PRTG will create a sensor for my logical disk. And then I will navigate to my sensor. I will do a manual scan and see what channels we have here. Okay, I'm on my sensor. I do scan now. And in a few seconds, we will see. Also, this sensor will be in a green state because our server is healthy. And then under the in the channel status, we will see the disk status and completion. Okay, we see this sensor is 100% completion and the disk status is okay. So it seems everything's fine with this sensor as well. Now we go back to our HPE ProLiant server. And now we will add a next sensor, and that will be a sensor for monitoring the network interface on our physical server. I go back to my HPE ProLiant server, and then I will click Add Sensor under the network device, and then I will type HPE ProLiant, and then I will click on the network interface. So this sensor will monitor the network interfaces on my server. PRTG will do a meta scan, discover available network interfaces. In this case, I will select all of them, and then I will click on Create. And now what PRTG will do, it will add sensor for each of these selected network interfaces. I will click on one of these interfaces. I will do a manual scan to establish connection between my sensor and my target network interface. And then in a few seconds, I will see this sensor states here. As we can see, it's in a green state, which means everything is healthy. And we have different channels here. We have traffic in, we have traffic out, we have total, we have late collisions, we have information about the FCS errors, carrier sense errors, and many different things under this channel. As you can see, this is in green state, which means we don't have any issues with the network interface on our HPE ProLiant 7. So the last sensor for today is a memory sensor. So I will do now, I will add now a memory sensor to my HPE ProLiant 7. I will navigate to memory and I will click Add Sensor. Then I will type HPE ProLiant again. And then I will click on HPE ProLiant memory controller. Then PRTG will do a meta scan and it will detect available memory controllers. I will select them and then I will click on Create. Then PRTG will establish connection with the target server and memory controllers. And then I will be able to see the state of my memory controllers. I will open my memory controller sensor. And I can see that this sensor is in health state and it shows different metrics in the channels, including controller condition. It says okay, controller error status, and different state of different modules in my physical service. So these were five sensors that I would like to show you on how you can use them to monitor your target HPE ProLiant service. Thank you for watching this video. If you found it helpful, please feel free to share it with your network on the social media. Please don't forget to hit like and hit subscribe. In case you have any questions, please let us know at support@pesla.com. Thank you.